Once a polytito. You may think that doesn't sound quite right, but believe me, once a polytito it is. And in this case, it was Goldiloppers. Goldiloppers trittly how in the early mordy, and she falloloped down the steps. Oh, unfortunate, for cracking of the eggers and the sheeps and the buttery full falollop and grazer kneeclappers. So she had a vasalubrious, rub it on and a quick healy huff, and that was that. So off she went, and she would trittly how down the garbage path, and at the left right-hand side goal, she passed a poo-pom. It was a humus heapy in the garbage, but never mind. She lost her whale. Now, this is a sadness, dear childers, because in the slight misty haze, which all foray, let me tell you, in the ephemeral foray, there's always a fairy control where the misty risey huff there, and so she was completely lost it. Oh, folly, folly. There was a cotty, so she went up, all ready with a basket, and picked up the butter, all that, with a little bit of birch, she'd scrape it off and rub it down her clothes. Mum would be cross, but never mind. On the door. This little cotty had a jar on the door, so she went in. Nobody there. Three baseload of porry on the tabloid, all slightly steamy huff, and nobody out. She called out,
"Anyone home?"
Nobody. Folly, folly, and a little hunger was with her, so she falloloped a taste out of the first basel. This was the large base load, and too over-salty for the flabe, spitty how, oh dear. Now, the mid-load was a middle flabe, which was not too over-salt, and a sugar flabe on her saliva glam, and it wasn't, of course, quite satisfactory. So she did a tasty most in the little base load there, and it was a joy, and oh, pardlow, as she snuffled it down, oh dear. Now, this was great, but there was also a little tiredness in the Goldiloppers, and she sat on a three-lebber stool, and tock for lolloper, all the lebbers floating across the corm, sat on a bocus there, bruisy most. Well, still, there was no one around, though she went prrrp-tock up the stair loaders, and she found a large bedding, not a capac or eiderdown, but stuffed with feathers, but here and there a stalk, as you know, it's a big feathers, the eagle-load, and it's stuck in her back, and it was most uncomfortable. So, she saw the cotty, and in this cot, she did lay down deep sleevers under the eiderdobe. Well, while she was thus sleepy and a deep dream of peaks, then up came the bears into the cotty. Now the father bold bear looking around and say, "Who's been tasting in stuff of my porry? Oh dear." And then the mother bear looking in her base load of porry and said, "Who'd be tasting in my porry? Oh, another finger." So the small bear came and said, "She's my base load and falloloping all down, mum. Oh dear, look, it's empty, not scratching on the bottom." And there was a general consternale uproar and complaint about the three-leopard stool there, all the bits and floaty, and so they had a look in around the house loader. Brrr, tock, big bear. Brrr, tock, middle bear. Brrr, st-t. They all went up the stair loaders, and soon there was a dent discovery in Mum and Dad's bedling, when the dirty footmark was where she did her trotly over and how, and then into the copst. And the little bear said, "Oh, look at it, Mum! This lame's the Goldiloppers!" But at this mode, she jumped up in the middle of her deep dream of sleep, piecey, out of the wind load, slide it and huff a load out of the drain pikers, and through the forry fast a whale. And they all looked such consternal through the wind load, they hadn't time to say, "You naughty girlage."